As well as a core focus on IT asset management, software licensing, and beyond within NetSupport DNA, the product offers a fairly unique proposition in terms of its summary information provided to deliver effective cost control within an organization. One of the new features in NetSupport DNA is our print monitoring feature, as shown on the toolbar here. As you'll see when we first enter the DNA console, our welcome screen provides us with some high-level stats, one of which is the number of pages that have been printed within our organization and the approximate printing cost this represents. Again, as always, this can be controlled by our date range within our view panel at the top of the screen. So let's pick our print monitor component, and you'll see again for yesterday, we have a breakdown by printer of the number of pages printed and the approximate cost associated with that printing. And as we drill down between individual departments, we're able to see specifically their printage usage and the printers they relate to. Of course, potentially, this gives us the opportunity now to recharge approximate printing costs between different departments in the organization, as well as monitor excessive print use. We can also group this summary and view the data by user rather than by specific printer. So how do we manage our printers within the enterprise? From our print monitor menu, we have our manage option. And from our manage option, as you can see, we have a dialog listing all network printers that have been discovered. And if we scroll down below that, we will have all local printers that have been discovered and recorded as part of our inventory scan. And below that, we have printers that we've excluded. This could either be printers we don't wish to monitor, or more typically, it will be other pseudo print services such as PDF writers and distillers that are recorded in the operating system as a printer but don't actually carry a tangible cost. To manage or exclude other printers that have been discovered, perhaps if we look on our list here, you'll see we have a fax. We can either select the individual item and choose to exclude it from our reporting, or we can right click on the individual printer and you'll see we're presented with a menu that allows us to quickly access the configure option to include a printer that has previously been excluded, exclude this printer, and perhaps the most useful of all is to exclude all printers that have the same name, particularly useful if we discover lots of PDF writers across the corporate enterprise. So a single click, exclude all, and that's automatically removed and added to our excluded section. Nice and simple and easy. So let's scroll back, and as you'll see, there's a distinction here between our black and white and our color printers. For each printer, we're able to select and configure that printer where we can assign an approximate cost per page for printing in both black and white or color. For much older printers, where printer drivers were less informative, we have the ability to ignore the copy count for certain devices where they don't support accurate information. Typically in a modern enterprise, that won't be required. So once we've configured the costings for each of our printers, we simply apply those settings and we're able to now print our reports for any given date period and show our print costs within the enterprise. Simple, powerful, and another great cost-saving feature within NetSupport DNA. Thank you for viewing this tour. Please visit www.netsupportdna.com to find out more, or if appropriate, download a free 30-day trial.